Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's Excel video, we're going to get into some financial stuff. I'm going to do vertical analysis on an income statement, but I will discuss vertical analysis of the balance sheet. So I have a sample income statement in front of me. For vertical analysis, there is always a base number for the income statement. It is your revenue. If you're looking at the balance sheet, the base number for assets would be total assets. And the base number for your liabilities and owner's equity would be total liabilities and owner's equity. Technically, you could use total assets because they have to match. Let's talk about the income statement first. So vertical analysis is always going to give us percentages. I want to know what percentage these numbers are of the base number, which is my revenue in cell B5. Before I even do this video, just a quick tip for you. If you want to know what formulas were used on this income statement, CTRL+G pulls up GoTo, go to Special and just select Formulas and click OK. Three cells are selected. The $320,000 is the revenue minus the cost of goods sold. Then down the $200,000, I just simply summed up the other expenses. And then I took the gross profit of $320 minus the total expenses to get to $120. Those are the only formulas I have here, just so you know that. One other tip, and this actually drives me crazy. I typed in other expenses, but for these five expenses, I did not do spacebar, 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 payroll. The way you put these in here is I typed in payroll through rent. I came to the alignment group and I just moved them over, and it's up to you how far you indent them. So that's how I did that. So here we go now with the vertical analysis. We've already mentioned this, the 600,000 is going to be the base number. Equals B5 divided by B5. That should give me 100%, or the number one. I do want to make this a mixed reference, so it's going to be B dollar sign five. I'm freezing row five, but I'm not freezing column B. I'll tell you why in 1 second. Control enter and just pull this down. If you get some zeros, you can get rid of them, not a problem. If you don't like the zeros, you could write an if statement, but since I've just got one, I'm going to get rid of it. I could also do control H. Find the zero and place with the blank. Now, before I even make these percentages, which is right here in the number group, oh, let me get rid of that, by the way. I'm going to undo, put them back. I'll tell you why. I want to take these borders that I have over in column B and move them over here. So just simply highlight and copy. And we're going to do a paste special, and I want to paste just the formats. There I go. Now I'm going to go make them percentages and get rid of that zero. So there is vertical analysis of an income statement. Everything is based on the revenue of 600,000. Our cost of goods sold is 47%, leaving us with a gross profit of 53%. Our net income or our earnings are 20% of our revenue. Now, vertical analysis, you only need one period, whatever this period is. It can be month, it can be quarter, it can be year. A lot of times with vertical analysis, though, we'll compare one company with another company. So just to show you this, I've already got this hidden, so let me just unhide it. Here's company B. Do you recall in this formula, I used a mixed reference? If I was looking at just company A, I could have used absolute cell reference. But the reason I use mixed is I can now copy this and paste it over into E, and notice it's D5 divided by D5. If I didn't use the mixed reference, I could not have done that. So an example of company A and company B, we could be looking at Lowe's and Home Depot, possibly Delta Airlines versus American Airlines, Microsoft and Apple. You can go on and on. Usually it's companies within the same industry you would be comparing vertical analysis to. So what's interesting about this is even though company B has more revenue and it has more revenue, but its net income is less. And also, if you notice, their cost of goods sold is actually a lot, 5% higher. So there is vertical analysis. It's always going to give you percentages right there, but it can be one period. Your horizontal analysis, which I'm going to do in another video, that would be multiple periods. I'm going to compare from the year 2018 to the year 2023 as an example. So that would be horizontal analysis, the same company, multiple periods for horizontal. Back to that balance sheet. If I had a balance sheet and I've got assets, total assets would be that base number. And then we've got assets of cash, accounts receivable, inventory, prepaid. If I see inventory is 70 or 80% of my total assets, that may be a red flag because that would be a high percentage of inventory to total assets. So you can see the advantage and you can see why vertical analysis is so great when you're analyzing financial statements. I hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to subscribe and ring the bell. Thank you for your support. Have a great day.